The 34th All India Conference of All India Kisan Sabha is being held at this Panchayat Bhavan of Hisar. And it is historically memorable for us because 25 years back in 1992 September, our 27th conference was held in this same venue. And that year, the government of India accepted the neoliberal economic policy. So first in our last, that conference, we passed a commission paper on neoliberal policy. And in those, we apprehended that what type of damage this neoliberal policy can create. Now after 25 years we came here in the 34th conference. So in this occasion we got a 25 years impact of this neoliberal policy on the life of farmers and the life of Indian people. So it is an opportunity for us to assess the impact of neoliberal policy in 25 years. During those days, no organization, all the Kisan organizations, they said it is good for the country. Indian farmer will be benefited by integrating with the international farming. But we opposed it and we thought that no, it will not happen. Fund bank philosophy will dominate and ultimately farmers will be in great difficulty in course of time. Apparently, our understanding was proved true. And those organizations like Bharatiya Kisan Union and all big kulak organizations, those who supported neoliberal policy, now they have all come round and say, no, no, this policy is very bad. It is damaging the farmers' interests. So we understood that this happened. And in this conference, we are evaluating in that how deep it was, its impact, and how the farmers are affected in different aspect of life. We will discuss that. So we decided to hold the conference here. And now it started the conference about 758 elected delegates from 25 states. They are participating. Now we are suffering by agrarian crisis, not problem. Problem can be solved, but crisis. Because of the people are committing suicide, because of they want to leave this as a profession, their children are not coming, because there is no future. So we want to discuss the depth of the crisis which started during this UPA government and intensified during this NDA rule. We will discuss that depth of the crisis, the different aspects of the crisis, that we will discuss here. Then other problem is that what are the strategy we should evolve to fight back? That also one of the area of discussion in the conference. Then another problem is there, when you are uniting the farmers, then the communal and caste forces are trying to divide the farmers. Another area of concern, how we will work or intensify our work to unify the farmers, how we will be able to engage in more and more social struggle and this unity of the people against casteism, communalism, all these aspects, the attack on the minorities in the name of cattle trade ban. So all these issues will come. How will unify the people, farmers? That will be another area of concern that will be discussed. Then it will be discussed, this government is making the country junior partner of the imperialist forces. But on the other hand, they are drum beating that they are the nationalist. Actually, they betrayed the nation during freedom struggle. Now they are becoming the champion of nation. That is fake nationalism. Indian patriotism is those who fighting for the people. So these aspects also, ideological aspects also, anti-imperialist aspect also, will evaluate and form a decision. United struggle is the most important necessity of the day. Four formation already formed. Kisan Sabha had a big role. That is, one is Bhumi Adhikar Andolan for 3 years, unitedly working. Then last 2 months, two organizations emerged. One is Rashtriya Kisan Mahasangh, 60 organizations are there. Another is All India Kisan Sangharsh Coordination Committee. About 170 organizations are there joined. We are in both the combination. We are also helping them to build up, and we are actively participating, because wherever farmers are struggling, we have to be there. So these two formations is fighting for two demands, 1.5 times price of the crops and low neighbor. But our organization had 15-point charter of demands for which we are campaigning, including these two, other demands are there. And we are taking those demands to the farmers. That created an atmosphere on which actually the present movement emerging. Last 3 years, we are campaigning this 15-point demand. Now we will concretize that. Farmers, half of the farmers are women, but feudal society, we do not recognize that women, they are farmers. They have no land right, they have no joint patta, they have no equal wage for equal work. So we will fight for that. And majority of women are coming in Rajasthan movement, in Maharashtra movement, more than men, women are coming in the struggle. So this is a new strength for the Kisan movement. So women should be mobilized more and more in the Kisan Sabha, in the not only in the rally, but in the organizational setup. Leadership will try to promote more and more members in them. Another problem, younger generation. That is also we have to mobilize. Being younger generation is now a bit frustrated. So how we can mobilize the younger generation and to encourage them to join in the battle. That area also is our concern. So all these organizational issues also we will take up and try to strengthen the organization so that we can bear the responsibility in coming days we are going to face.